need to chug university. Okay.
Thank you. Team back in Greece, so it's consisted by leading by Professor Simos. It's consisted by me and Professor Famelis. We are collaborating Professor have produced numerous of papers which are focus in numerical solution of ordinary differential equations and especially differential equations that have some special property having oscillating or periodic solutions. These include celebrated problems like Schrödinger and other problems like orbits, Kepler, and other problems, some very well known to everybody, I believe, problems such as Bessel, Duffing, etc. All these problems having periodic or oscillatory solutions are of our interest. Have produced a number of papers, especially in exploiting some special properties like phase lag, instability, etc. Meaning that we are trying to imitate the solutions of these problems, the periodic problems, to reduce the phase lag, which is the angle between the numerical and the theoretical solution, to try to find methods that share the property of p-stability, which is useful when the problem is stiff, meaning that you have problem which is that when you linearize them, you have eigenvalues with very small non-positive, negative, very big, I say, negative real parts. Now we are trying to expand our research in some modern areas, for example, fractional differential equations, use various evaluatory techniques and other techniques from computational intelligence in this numerical analysis problem of us. There is no extent, I would say there is a rather limited literature combining computational intelligence, meaning neural networks, combinatory algorithms, etc., and numerical analysis. I'll focus here in a talk about neural network and differential equations. We have already made some research in the past, okay, assisting. Research in this area in the past. And our focus until now was in some other direction, from the direction that I'll talk A little brief, briefly today, you can use neural networks in various ways in numerical analysis, as it seems. Well, what is an artificial neural network? Okay, here is biology, where I will not explain very much. And here is the similar figure for numerical analysis. Actually, in here we have the so-called nerve neuron, which in numerical analysis are not various electrical signals, but are weights and inputs that are combined in a certain neuron and transfer function, and the output is this value there, and this imitates what is done in real life in neuron in our brain, where some signals, electrical signals, come, and then with some way there is an output from all this procedure done here. Okay, neural networks, of course there is some problem with the theory behind them. Many people use them perhaps not in the proper way. 25-30 years before, some basic work was done and proved that neural network is actually a universal approximator. I would say universal minimizer. It's the same thing, because approximation actually minimizes the error between the function you want to approximate and the polynomial or rational function that you use for this approximation. So a neural network can approximate a function and its derivative. That's the reason that neural networks are used nowadays. This approximation does not need to be a polynomial. For example, various functions like sigmoid or log normal, etc., can be used. This f shown before here, this f of something. This f is not polynomial. It's generally some functions like that said before, sigmoid, etc. About 20 years ago, Lagaris et al. Introduced a new idea in order to solve a differential equation using a neural network. At the beginning, I have to say that they are trying to minimize some error of their estimator, the neural network, and the solution of the differential equation. It's something like this. The neural network, the solution was differentiable. The solution has very good generalization properties. For example, you can get a continuous extension easily of the solutions. I remind here that numerical solutions do not furnish continuous solutions. approximations to the solution. All Merkle methods actually give us approximations of these points. Okay. Excuse me. Of course, there are some limitations. The function and its first order, we can approximate a function and its derivative when this function is its derivatives, first derivative, is continuous. And of course, the function, the hidden layer of the neural network are sufficiently differentiable. Let's see the general differential equations problem. This is the general form of differential equations. This equation can be an initial value problem or a boundary value problem analogous to our wishes. Thus, we're going to solve this using a neural network. Now, we assume a discretization in the domain, that its boundary, and to a set of points x, I, and then we have the following system of equations. Something constraints, of course, there are analogously if we have an initial or boundary value problem. So, let this be a suitable trial solution with P, a vector of parameters that are adjustable. Then we are actually have a minimization problem. Differential equations become a minimization problem. Of course, this is a question. Is worth or minimization problem is more difficult problem than solving directly differential equations with the very well-known methods, Ricci-Kutta, Malmsted, etc. Neural networks are not the solution for everything. For example, I have to say here, so obviously that for a problem no stiff problem, SIP problem, it's not good to use a neural network. Not approach that I'm saying here. For example, if you have a very simple or even for example, non-stiff problem. For example, if you have, I hope you see, something like this, for example, there is no need to use it. You can use the standard methods, or even in a small system, you can use the standard methods. For this problem, you can choose a Ricci-Kutta and solve it at no time. No need to use a neural network. Don't need this. You can solve using 10 points, pass a method, a math method, and at no time you can solve the problem in any interval you want. So why transpose this problem to a minimization problem and then try to use Jacobians, Newton iterations, etc., in order to solve the minimization problem. This minimization problem comes after using a neural network. Neural network actually transforms the whole thing to a minimization problem. And there are various methods used in neural networks in order to proceed. So this type of problems, non-Steve problems, other Steve problems, it's not good to be solved this way, because you simply add confusion without reason. Neural networks, since you transpose the differential equation to a minimization problem, it's better to be used in hard problems, large stiff problems, large difficult problems, so orbits with many stars, etc., where there is probably some kind of chaos in it. Problems where it's worth spending time for solving the minimization problem. Otherwise, it's not good. American ordinary differential equations is an area that has come almost to the limit for the simple problems. Cannot so many things to solve, and of course you cannot just solve with some difficult and time-consuming method just in order to say this. Unfortunately, in the literature I see this to happen. Solve everything with neural networks that consume much more time than the original and well-known methods. So actually, we transform the problem to the minimization problem, which is actually the neural network. These are the points we are based. These are, as you see, the comes from the differential equation, and we begin with a trial solution. So this is the neural network, where actually it's a function. It's a function of this F shown before. Here, functions of these sums. W are weights to be found, and of course, X are the points that we are based for in the interval of integration. So this P here actually are adjustable weights that have to be found. So we can use a single input output feedforward network. Lagarin did this, and A is actually comes from the initial or boundary value that we have at the beginning. Okay, the neural network for a scalar ODE, here is the input. These are called the layer. The layer is getting this X, and with a function like this we saw before, there is some sum here. We apply F, and which is F on this sum shown before, and then we get the output. This is a bias added at the end. What we want is to find these weights summed in the pair, for example, and give inputs, and the neural network will give us outputs, meaning the solution at various points. What is the, this F shown before? Usually is not allowed to be any function. The neural networks, imitating the biological origin, uses various functions like sigmoid, see here, hyperbolic tangent, as you see here, from actually this go from minus one to one. Anyway, this is minus one. Excuse me, but so let's see some problems. For example, let's say that you have this simple problem, not to be solved actually if it's a non-stiff case with neural network, but let's see it for simplicity. So, the trial solution, since we have initial value problem, the trial solution is this one, and the function to be minimized, actually, in numerical analysis and mathematical point of view, is actually this function here. In electrical engineering, as you know, they like to draw various graphs like the one shown before. Actually, we have this function to be minimized because neural networks, from our point of view, is a minimizer. From the boundary value problem case, you have the left, the right, so this is nullified. Analogous, you have the case used, and the function to be minimized is this one. So, I will not go further, just we can see some other case, the second order, it's another function to be minimized actually. For the systems case, of course, in case you have a system of differential equations, then you have double S here, etc. And let's see an example. Let's take a mildly stiff problem, the Van der Pol system, which is this system shown here. We train a neural network to solve in this interval where the solution is known for this interval. You can see trying okay, here it's ODE 2-3S, ODE 2-3, ODE 4-5 from MATLAB. You can see that these functions from MATLAB failed to solve this problem. Of course, it's a peculiar case, okay, you found. And neural network, like this we saw before, behave very well. it actually finds the solution. Well, standard methods from MATLAB fail absolutely for this problem. Of course, neural networks are expected to behave better in difficult problems, delayed differential equations. We have a first paper published already in this case. Stiff differential equations and other, of course, I would say, more difficult problems. For example, what do we mean with a stiff differential equation? If here this number was, for example, 1 million, then this problem they called stiff. This is the type of problems that these methods are different from MATLAB, for example, except perhaps this. It's a BDF method. It's impossible to solve anyway. For this problem, since we have to use Newton iterations, evaluations of Jacobians, etc., then neural network approach for solving differential equations is supposed to be beneficial. We have published various papers until now in neural networks, but our approach until now was a little different. This paper. There is another way to use neural networks, and this is to see here coefficients trained to perform better in classical orbits. We can use also neural networks in a different approach. Try a standard method, a Rugi-Kutta pair or other methods, and try to train the coefficients. Of course, there is no just one Rugi-Kutta method, there are infinitely many. You can change the coefficients. So, neural networks can be used in another way. Train the coefficients of a method in order to perform better in a class of problems, orbits, Hilatori, Hamiltonian, etc. And this was done back in 2002 for the first time, and we can use this approach was used various times, and this year, in order to train the coefficients in this approach, we have some test problem, for example, say two-pole problem, and train the method to integrate all this problem to the end and adjust the coefficients in order to behave best. Then it's found that a method with these trainable coefficients behaves better in a whole class of problems, for example, orbits, not only the two poles, but here it was proved that in the whole class of two bodies with various eccentricities, for the Areshkov problem, for Pleiades problem with the seven stars, etc., many collisions, etc., it was found that. And here that the methods, the new methods, were better than the classical methods. This is a different approach, training the coefficients. Since we have to expand our research in various areas, I think this area is very good for our research. Neural network approach, as said before, can be applied to boundary value problems where we can have to solve again nonlinear systems of equations. Simple initial value problems are not appropriate for neural network methods to be used, as said before. But in fuzzy differential equations, fractional differential equations, it's believed to have better results. For the delayed differential equations and neutral differential equations, we have the first, unfortunately, I forgot to write it, first result that was extraordinary because for this type of problems, classical methods are far behind from the methods for the standard initial value problems. And of course, there are other computational intelligence methods that can be used in our research, like differential evolution, etc., which also can be used, have been used actually in combination with neural networks. For example, when here we try to train the coefficients, these coefficients are not trained with classical backpropagation, etc., but actually this training is based on differential evolution technique from this type of algorithm. So I think this was enough for our studies, and we hope to proceed with Professor Alloyan, our team partner. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, I'd like to thank Dr. Vistelas for his presentation. Now I'll allow any questions. Any questions?
Okay, thank you very much.